Rita Ontiveros denies allegations she bribed a Pharmally employee to testify against the firm in the ongoing probe at the Senate. That accusation came from the camp of detained Pharmally official Linconn Ong as they released a video of a firm's employee making the claim. And joining us now, we have Attorney Topacio, lawyer of Linconn Ong. Attorney Ferdinand Topacio, good morning, sir.
Good morning, Ma'am Karen. It's always good to be back.
All right, Attorney Topacio, it is serious business to accuse a senator or her office of bribing a witness to testify in the Senate. What basis do you have, and tell us how this employee came to be?
Actually, to make things clear, and I lucidly explained this during the press con yesterday, I am not doing any accusing. All I did was release a video of a person who claims that he has personal knowledge of bribery on the part, well, at least of the confirmed members of the staff of Senator Arisa Ontiveros, namely Attorney Jay Bekema and Juan Ryan Tazo. And this video was sent to me by Pharmally and for evaluation as to what they should do with it. I did not swallow it hook, line, and sinker at the time, so I asked for verification. I had my lawyers talk to the witness, and not content with that, I asked them to put down his testimony in black and white and authenticated before a notary public before I decided.
So this particular witness, let's make it clear. This employee approached Pharmally. So Pharmally shot his video.
Yes, he's an employee of Pharmally, and he approached management and said that he could no longer keep his peace. That he was saddened by the way that certain officials of Pharmally were being slandered, and that he offered his testimony to them. They put it down on video and sent it to me for legal evaluation.
And this employee, did he have details? For example, he claims that he was aware. Is that correct?
Yes, that is
the lawyer from Senator Risa Ontiveros' office tried to bribe. Who did he try to bribe? The witness that Senator Risa showed?
Yes, the witness called BJ, who testified that there was tampering with the production dates of a certain batch.
And how would Attorney Topacio, this witness that Pharmally presented, who claims to know of bribery to have taken place, which is coming from that witness that Senator Risa presented, how would he know of this alleged bribery?
Well, he claims to have personal knowledge of it, and it is all outlined in the sworn statement, which contains more details than the video which we presented.
You've read this statement?
Yes, in fact, I have a copy in my office. The other lawyers have copies, and actually, we will not let it end here, just to dispel any doubts that this is being done to besmirch the reputation of a public official. That's why I enlisted the aid of the Citizens Crime Watch, because we will be assisting this witness and giving him protection. And eventually, cases will be filed before the ombudsman in connection with the testimony of this witness.
Okay, but how did he know of the bribery? You said he has personal knowledge. So I'm
I do not want to go into details because it might give clues as to his identity, which we are closely guarding at the moment. But rest assured, in just a few days, we are just completing the paperwork and some other details. We will go to the proper forum, and then his identity will be divulged and the full extent of his knowledge will be made public.
But then, is he a friend of the witness that Senator Ontiveros presented? Was he in the room when the alleged bribery occurred?
He claims to have personal knowledge. A person who allegedly gave false testimony is a close colleague. That is why we evaluated it. And we would not have a presented it if it were hearsay or if the connection between the supposed bribe giver, which belongs to the staff of Senator Ontiveros, and the person who gave testimony, which is BJ, is tenuous. We would not risk that. We are making sure that there is a good case, and we will leave it up now to the proper forum to decide whether or not there is cause to hold anyone liable for any criminal offense.
And I'm curious what the supposed bribe was. Did he say an amount of money?
Well, it was valuable consideration, definitely. And that will be revealed in the coming days. We just need a few more days because things have been a little hectic because of the continued confinement of Mr. Ong and the fact that his mobile phone was taken from him, which gives us difficulty in communicating with Mr. Ong.
Okay. Senator Risa Ontiveros' office, and she herself, is of course contesting these allegations, and they have email threads to prove that it was BJ who actually reached out to them. So if that's... go ahead.
Well, that is their version. We respect that. That is why I'm saying we are making no judgments as to the guilt or innocence of any person, as to who between our witness and BJ is lying. And that is why our only job here is to evaluate the testimony and to determine whether there is a reasonable ground to bring it to the proper forum.
All right. Now, when it comes to Linconn,
we will leave it at that. Whether the proper forum decides.
Let's now move to your client, Linconn Ong. Senator Ping Lacson said that if he does not cooperate with the Senate, he may stay there. He may be detained till Christmas. Is he planning to cooperate?
Well, those are the same threats that they give to every witness who does not say what they want to say. I've been hearing that since 2008 when I appeared in the Fertilizer Fund inquiry. And it's the same tandem of Lacson and Gordon who keeps bullying witnesses. You know, as I've said, it is their right to exercise their power of contempt in a despotic manner, as it is our right to question their exercise of the power of contempt before the proper court. We cannot prevent them from unjustly detaining my client. He is in custody. They have the Senate Sergeant at Arms to enforce their orders, but we will resort to the proper forum. This is a legal question. This is not a question of opinion of Mr. Lacson or Mr. Gordon or SP Soto. This is a legal question that I believe now should be given an authoritative ruling by the Supreme Court, because for so long, Ma'am Karen, the Senate has been abusing its exercise of contempt powers. This has got to stop. And if there is one silver lining that may come out of this whole Pharmally investigation fiasco, is that the Supreme Court may finally rule that the Senate cannot arbitrarily and summarily exercise its contempt powers in the manner that it is doing it now.
So clearly you are taking this to the Supreme Court.
Definitely. And, you know, my client is, he's so depressed. He's being subjected to mental torture, even by the sergeant at arms of the Senate.
What's he saying? It's mental torture. What is the Senate sergeant of arms doing?
Well, for one, if the public must know, Ma'am Karen, that when I was already there, when I visited my client very early on Monday, and I was already in his room, and the sergeant at arms found out, he ordered his men to escort me out of the room. Of course, I refused. I insisted on my client's right to be heard by counsel and to consult with a lawyer. But they were insistent, so I told them, and they were so apologetic, but they said, "Sir, pasensya na kayo, order lang." Sabi ko, it's okay, you can implement the order, but if you really want me out of this room, you will have to bodily carry me. Mm-hmm. Well, of course, they relented. They probably thought it would be such a chore to carry 180 pounds out of the room. At any rate, and then after I left, the sergeant-at-arms talked to my client, ex parte, without the presence of counsel, and said that walang kwenta yan si Topacio, hindi ka matutulungan yan, lalong lalala ang problema mo pag nag-abogado ka, etc., etc. I have it all on record. And these things were witnessed. The attempt to force me out of the room was witnessed by a member of my staff.
Okay.
And then this echoed, yes, I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. I wanted to ask you, Attorney Topacio, but why did Linconn Ong change his mind? In the beginning, he was willing to speak in an executive session, to tell the truth in an executive session. He spoke with Senator Ping Lacson privately, and I think Senate President Ito Sotto, and he did already mention Michael Young's name to the two senators privately. Why the sudden change? Why doesn't he just speak the truth if he has nothing to hide?
Well, the truth that the senators, these senators, Lacson, Gordon, Sotto, the truth that they want him to speak is not the truth. They are importuning him. Pressure is being brought to bear on him in an executive session to point to President Duterte and Senator Bongo. Actually,
senators tell him that?
They did. I was informed. And he said, paano ko sasabihin yun? Hindi naman talaga totoo. Whatever consent he may have given before was because of pressure. And then when he was able to coolly reflect on the participation in the executive session during the weekend, he began to have second thoughts. That's when he contacted me. It was a Sunday. I was doing groceries in a Unimart, and then from out of the blue, I got a message saying, sir, this is Linconn Ong of Pharmally. Your number was given to me by a friend. Okay. Could you call? Yeah. And then I talked to him and I visited him the day after.
All right. Okay. But Attorney Topacio, honestly speaking, even the agreement or the testimony of Ms. Mago, Crizel Mago, corroborates, for example, with the change in expiration dates and all the other issues that's being hounded and thrown against Pharmally. When she was asked, did you swindle the government? She said, I believe so, yes.
And that
She said she was ordered herself. So it's important. Okay, I'm sorry. She herself said that she was ordered to change those expiration dates. So number one, it corroborates with VJ's testimony. And then Linconn Ong, being the head of Pharmally, is important in terms of Ms. Magus' statement that she was ordered to change those expiration dates too. Why won't he just testify and say if that's true or not?
Well, for one, we have to clarify that spin of the senators. It was not the expiration date that was changed. It was the production date. Those are two different things. Number two, as the recent statement of Ms. Mago states, it would appear that she was bamboozled and cornered into saying those things. You know, that is the problem why my client had second thoughts about going into executive session. He told me, if I can be bullied, if I can be insulted, if I can be terrorized in an open session where the public and the media may watch, who knows what they can do to me in an executive session, which is closed door. And all that he consulted me with was whether or not he had the right to refuse. And I told him, you have the right to refuse. You have the right not to incriminate yourself. Even the Senate rules state that the rights of a witness must be respected. And it is only this Blue Ribbon Committee that does not respect these rights. When TJ Gingona was the chairman and I was appearing there, every invocation of the right to remain silent and against self-incrimination was respected.
Okay, last words, Attorney Topacio. I don't have enough time, but what is your plan? Do you have a target on when to have Linconn Ong out of Senate detention?
Well, very soon we are preparing the necessary documents, the petition to be filed. Of course, we are hampered by the fact that we cannot communicate with our client. But we tried, and in fairness to the Senate, they allowed one of our lawyers to see him yesterday. Okay. My only message to the senators is, gentlemen, you are not above the law. You are not the law. You may make the law, but you are not the law. I hope that you will see it in your hearts and in your minds that what you are doing is not only legally wrong, it is not only constitutionally wrong, it is morally wrong. Thank you.
On that note, Attorney Ferdinand Topacio, thanks for joining me this morning.